Welcome, visitor, to an account of the history of Busselton, Western Australia. Originally, southwestern Western Australia has been occupied for at least 50,000 years. The sea people, whose traditional country included Busselton, called themselves the Wardandi, and they were members of the Noongar speaking group. In 1801, Nicholas Baudin led a French expedition which made the first European landing on southwest Australia. Commanders Baudin and Hamelin named Geographe Bay and Cape Naturaliste after their respective vessels. From the beginning of the 19th century, the sheltered waters of Geographe Bay provided a haven for American whalers and sealers. Recognition of the Baudin expedition is provided by this plaque and sculpture. The plaque tells us that the 19th of October in 1800, the Baudin expedition set sail from the Havre in Normandy, France, with two ships. Captain Nicholas Baudin, second in command, was Emmanuel Hamelin. There were 23 scientists engaged in the domains of astronomy, botany, geology, mineralogy, horticulture, and geography. The ships anchored at the present Geographe Bay in 1801, and contact was made with the indigenous people. Midshipman Vasse, after whom a river is named, was drowned. The expedition was responsible for valuable natural history, more than 200,000 specimens of flora and fauna, of which 2,500 were new to science, doubling the number of known species at the time. The expedition was responsible for hundreds of French place names in Australia, of which 240 are still in use today. Baudin charted nearly two-thirds of the Australian coastline, filling gaps in the rudimentary Dutch maps, making the first detailed charts of the west and northwest coasts of WA. An early sketch of Baudin's ship. Geographe Bay was used in the early 1800s by American whalers. Their whaling ships looked like this. There's a biography of the Busseltons who settled around Busselton between 1829 to 1841. It's now in the public domain and can be found in full on Wikipedia. It's called Cattle Chosen. Busselton, besides being the center of some farming country, established itself as a leading port. In 1850, timber was being exported and a small town prospered. Jetties for the exported timber were constructed along the coastline, but only the Busselton Jetty remains. In the Busselton Jetty Museum, old timber tools are on display. The virgin forest of the time was immense, required strong arms to heft these broad axes. Much of the early work was done by horses and bullocks. Here timber is being moved in Jarrahdale. With the development of the steam engine, there was an immediate need for transported timber to the coast. The Ballarat steam train is still located in Busselton across Queen Street in St. Mary's Park. It's the oldest train in WA, built in Victoria in 1871, and was used for hauling timber. Certainly not very large. Railway development was rapid by the middle to the end of the 19th century. WA's first railway line was built just north of Busselton at Lockville in 1871 and was used to transport timber. From 1927 to 1957, Busselton was also on the West Australia Government Railway line running from Bunbury to Flinders Bay. The old line was eventually closed. The railway line also connected onto Busselton Jetty and was not closed on the jetty until the 1970s. Using a railway to move the timber. With the prospering of the timber industry and the pastoral industry came the development of some fairly substantial colonial housing. One of the interesting landmarks is St. Mary's Church of England. One of the prettiest is St. Mary's, built in 1844 and 1845. Claims to be the oldest stone church in WA and was the brainchild of John Mowry and John Garrett Bussell, who had trained as a clergyman. It was consecrated in 1848. The setting of the church beside the river is enhanced by the gravestones around the back, some of which date back to 1841. Another building from the period used as an art shop. This is the old courthouse. Now we look at the history of the Busselton Jetty. There's an old bronze plaque that describes some of the information. Horse-drawn wagons carried timber and farm produce originally. The railway jetty was opened in 1911. The port was closed in 1972. The 1978 Albie destroyed almost 600 meters. There was also the construction of the Busselton Jetty. It's one of the most distinctive structures in Busselton today. The original jetty was built at Jarrah. Permission was given to build it in 1853, but it was not completed until 1865, being 528 feet. It was added to in 1875 with an additional 430 feet. A further stage was added so that today it's nearly 2 kilometers long, one of the longest jetties in the world. It was closed to shipping in 1972 and damaged by a cyclone in 1978. Today it's used by fishermen and holiday makers. Inside the museum of the jetty is this description. The Busselton Jetty played a key role in the growth of the district. It facilitated the trading of agricultural supplies work by the Busselton Jetty Environmental and Conservation Association to raise funds for the restoration and maintenance of the jetty. The tourist train, which used to run on the jetty, but does no more. I appreciate your company on this brief visit through a history of Busselton, Western Australia. I do hope you have a good day.